good. I like that. Now, he is one of two eagle species here in BC. The other is the golden eagle. Yeah, you're good. You know your eagles hang out. Next to the water. And they like water because of their favorite food. And their favorite food is?
Fish,
that's right. I don't even need to be here. You can answer all my questions. Now, he is North America's fishing eagle, and he's really, really good at it. He's got that big, broad wingspan. He'll swoop on down, and if you were to touch the underside of Hercules' feet, you'd notice he has kind of a rough, sandpapery texture. It's quite abrasive, and that really allows him to hold on to the water. Now, Hercules is actually a pretty good fisher. Do you guys want to see him fish?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's see if we can get him back up the hill one more time. Once he's done cleaning my glove here, that's a serve. Wow. Pretty good. Let's give him a round of applause. He makes that look easy. Oh, he dropped his food. He uses those feet, he shoots them out, snatches that meat right off the surface. He makes it look so easy. And that's cool. That very distinct white head and tail that he's sporting, that's how we associate bald eagles. But I'll tell you what, when he was born, he was completely brown from head to toe. It actually takes about 7 years to develop that coloration. They get a little more white every year. So that's how other eagles know that he's ready to maybe get into a relationship. It's like signing up for an eagle dating service. Eagle Tinder, or his favorite, Plenty of Fish. Yeah, there's more to come. Just wait for him. Now, Hercules here is full grown, and he's a pretty imposing bird. He's about 6 feet tip to tip on the wing there. Would anyone like to take a guess? How much do you think he weighs? 9 pounds, great guess. Anybody else?
13 pounds.
Got 13 pounds, going up. Anybody else?
Well, I should say, females are the bigger gender, about 30% larger.
So a female bald eagle would probably weigh somewhere from about 9 to 12 pounds. Now that allows him to catch a pretty big fish, but these guys don't. Hercules here is a very wonderful bird. We're happy to work with him. We're actually happy to sport about 50%, or 25% rather, of that wild bald eagle population right here in BC. And that's because we have lots of water. Big ocean coastline, lakes, rivers, streams, lots. In the 60s and in the 70s, we used a pesticide called DDT. Crush under the weight of them. Now luckily, we got our act together. We banned DDT, and I'm happy to say that Hercules is a lot like her, just smaller, different coloration. But look, number one, that sharp downwards turned beak for ripping and tearing. Those are number three. Now this here isn't, this right here is a Harris's hawk. Now Harris's hawks are really wonderful birds. He's the only non-native bird you're gonna see in today's demonstration. Watch any sort of demonstration just like ours. There's a very good chance you might meet a Harris hawk. I think he's just lost his line of sight there. Let's see if I can go. Now the reason Harris hawks are so cool is that if you were to go down into the southern United States, maybe Arizona, Nevada, New Mexico, wherever you find them, you're gonna see this bird right here hunting in family packs. They're a pack hunting raptor. They hunt in family groups of the Harris hawks.
Whoa.
I'm right here. Can go after something as large as a jackrabbit. Now a jackrabbit may not seem impressive to you or me. Would it be like any one of you here in the audience going? Even other birds are on the menu if you are a Harris hawk like Vega. You all right? Did he freeze you there? Now, show it makes him incredibly maneuverable up in the sky. They'll actually catch other birds on the wing. Pluck them right out of the air. All right, and here's the toss.
Oh.
No problem. Let's give him a round of applause. Hey, mate. It's especially named for those killing talons they use. He kind of looks a little like this. Let's say hello to Vulture. That bright red head gives him away. Very distinctive a turkey vulture. Now turkey vultures are fast. So he has to find things that have already had an untimely demise. He's a carry-on eater, he's a scavenger. Now it's actually tough being a scavenger. You don't always know when your next meal's gonna be. And so you have to be efficient. You can't waste energy if you might not eat for a day or two. He's less than half as much as a bird. Like a bald eagle, he's only about 3 pounds. So he can catch a thermal, ride the warm air up into the sky. He can ride for up to 6 to 7 hours on a single flap of his wings if all goes well. Now he's not idly flying, he's constantly looking for food. And he's got a really cool way of doing that. When you're looking at him, you'll see he has big eyes. They're not quite as keen as something as a raptor. But he can still see very, very well. He's got to find them wherever they might have died, under a forest canopy, in a cave, under your kid's bed. Wherever something's dead and rotting, he can seek it out. Now, they're really, really good at it. And I'll tell you what, that great big opening, sometimes gets food caught in it. He can use that middle toe. Ground is because he's got flat feet, like a stork or a chicken. As you can imagine, you don't get many flying dead things or running dead things, so he can come to them. And he can walk up to that carcass. He's going to plant with those flat feet. He's going to use the leverage to tear and to rip with his razor-sharp feet. Now, while we're looking at his feet, I'll tell you another cool thing about turkey vultures. He's got a nice chalky white color down his legs. That's because Judge here likes to pee down his legs. Now, he pees down his legs for a couple reasons. Number one, there's actually quite a lot of water in that urine. It evaporates. It actually helps keep him cool, much like sweating would work for you and I. Pee down your legs to stay cool. Works for him, it'll work for you. Important as well, because they also have strong stomach acid. So strong, in fact, that Judge Dredd here can actually eat things that have died of diseases. So they do an important job cleaning up ecosystem supplies as he heads up. Chuck. Effective predators you're ever gonna meet. In fact, these birds are so good at what they do, they're often called the death.
Turn my head around.
Yeah.
And grab.
She's really cool.
I think they're owls. And muscular owls hunt a lot in the dawn and the dusk under forest canopies. It's still pretty dark, but they are a sound. A sound comes from the forest floor each year at a different time, so she knows exactly where it is. Now, to put this in perspective, if we were all completely silent, standing here, you could hear all of your hearts beating.
Using her incredible host of skills, Danny here can go after everything from small mammals, other owls, up to and including prey as large as porcupines.
I don't know how you hunt a porcupine, but very carefully is probably the answer. But her absolute favorite food is black and white and smelly. Do you know what it is? Skunk, that's absolutely right. Someone said penguins. Let's give her a big round of applause. All right, there. Okay, come on down. Yeah, not on the box. There you go. And we'll tuck her away. Now, I have one more bird for you. Do you have time? Captain, the falcon is a close relative of a peregrine. He's out in the northern hemisphere here in Canada and around the globe. Now, they're really incredible birds. They come from a bunch because they are specialized bird hunters. Falcons like Captain and Peregrine, they go to go after other birds on the wing. So he's going to use his great... I'm going to give him another pass here. But he's losing energy, it's really hot and it's hard work. Let's see if he'll catch it. Hey, he's got it. Let's give him a round of applause. A really wonderful flight. Now, if you don't sweat, it all comes out through the mouth. Number two, he's got his wings down. What he's doing is he's covering that lure. Now, I told you something like an eagle would love to kick other birds off their prey. That includes falcons. So he wants to hide it from you, the hungry audience. Often they've worked very, very hard for their food, and they don't want to give it away right away. Now I'm going to get him up nice and close. You can take a good look at him to see the finer features that make falcons oh so wonderful. Check out that great big chest. He's very muscular. Gives him a very strong wing flap, and those arrows
are actually very necessary if you are a falcon like Captain. Flying is your livelihood, so you don't want to get in a struggle with something like a duck or a goose where you could break a feather or break a bone. Now, Captain here is the last bird of the demonstration. If you want to get a closer look at him, I'm actually going to spend the next 5 to 10 minutes right up in the front center so you can come say hi, ask me any questions that you want answered. I don't bite.
If he does, please do not touch him. I ask that you check out everything else going on the mountain today. There is a lumberjack show going on at 4:30. There's the ropes course, there's the Iowa wind, and we are actually back on one more time at 5:30 to round out the day. We appreciated the birds. Thank you very much. And on behalf of all of us, and especially them, thanks for coming.
Nice.
Five birds.
Yeah.
I think that the time we went is only four birds.
Oh.
Yeah. It's great. His is great. His presentation.